My name is Kaarel Krjutškov, and I'm the director of Selvia laboratory. We operate as an independent laboratory providing up-to-date services in medicine and food safety.
Hi. My name is Kairi Raime and I am Honey Project Manager at Selvia Laboratory. Selvia Laboratory is the first who launched so comprehensive honey DNA metagenomic analysis as a service.
After all scandals that have happened lately, European professional beekeepers asked us as a Selvia researchers and lab staff to come here to introduce the method that revealed the proportion of the fake honey on the market. So we decided to come and talk more and educate people what happens behind the curtains. After the big scandal on the German market, European professional beekeepers asked us as Selvia researchers and lab staff to come here to introduce the method and the laboratory work more deeply. That was the reason why we were asked to come here.
Attention please, and good morning and heartily welcome to our conference today.
And I'm really the guy who tried to convince you based on the data that yes, there is maybe one solution that maybe helps the beekeepers in the future. Another brave lady sits here, Lynn. She delivered us also 30 anonymous products from market, including 5 authentic samples from United Kingdom. Yep. And what came out? We nicely identified, Lynn's provided 5 authentic samples without any problems. And surprisingly, one sample out of 24 was authentic. The rest failed based on our analysis. Okay, I have one good example left. Wolfgang is there. Yeah, hi Wolfgang. We made a collaboration with Wolfgang and he delivered us 30 totally anonymous samples, again including 5 authentic ones from Austria. Even I was surprised. We of course identified 5 authentic honey samples nicely, without any problems. All 25 samples failed. It means the failure percentage was 100%. Then I calculated the, is it the chance? You can calculate. Is it the chance to detect 5 samples incidentally among those 30? And the probability to hit the 5 samples incidentally, it's 0.0003%. In other words, yes, DNA helps to find authentic honeys and distinguish them from the fake ones, no doubt. There is no revolution because it was just time who brings the honey total DNA technology to your world. It is just a question of time. The total DNA sequencing will be the standard soon. It doesn't happen in 3 months, but it happened in 2 or 3 years. And that is normal progress. Just adapt or die. That is my message. That's all from my side. This 3-hour seminar included 3 presentations and a long discussion. From the presenter view, I felt that the interest of audience was deep. There were many related questions, very good questions about the topic. The questions didn't surprise us because we were familiar about those ones. I also saw that the audience was a bit polarized because two different interests were represented, the professional beekeepers and of course the current testing laboratories and authorities were represented. Personally, I felt that the ice started to thaw, and yes, we realized that it doesn't happen overnight, as in the spring, if the first sun comes out, then the snow doesn't disappear immediately. But it takes some time, and as in every spring, the ice and snow disappears, and finally there will be nice and sunny summer. And the same will happen with the beekeepers.
Developing these kind of DNA-based methods have been very interesting journey for me, and it's important topic for me personally as well, because my grandmother and grandfather were beekeepers. My mother is beekeeper. For me personally, it's very important that I can support honest honey production.
It was very, very important that they came here to Germany and explained the DNA analysis method, because a lot of people were talking about the method without knowing it. And the only way to know more about the method is to have to explain it by the people who are doing it. And this is what has happened. Kairi and Kaarel came to Germany. They showed how it is done and why it is working. And this was very important to push forward the Save the Honey movement and Clean Up the Honey Market movement.